I'm Allison Van Hooser, and I'm on a sold-out mission to develop highly successful leaders at all levels. In the 15 years I've been working throughout the food, financial, retail industries, and politics, I have become deeply aware of the powerful effects of leadership. In each episode, you will get strategies and actions you can use immediately in order to change you, your team, and your business. The question is, will you choose to own it? Will you put your stake in the ground and decide to do something with what you've learned today? This is Stake, the Leadership Podcast.
One-on-one time with my husband the other night didn't quite turn out the way I originally thought it would. Joe and I have four kids, one of those being a newborn, so sleep is really hard to come by in our house, and adult alone time, well, he and I are in this really, really wild season where we sit back and reminisce about days when we would do crazy things like eat our food when it was still hot. Now, baby Holt, as we call her, she still wakes up multiple times during the night. So usually when she goes down around 9 p.m., I do too, because every extra minute of sleep counts right now, right? But he and I are missing each other, so we've started making more of an effort to spend time with one another. A few nights ago, after laying Holt down and crawling out like a ninja, you parents know what I'm talking about, I gently shut that door and I ran on my tiptoes to the living room and found my husband working on his laptop. Now, as I came in the living room, he shut his laptop, sort of a universal signal that he was turning off work, and we were both checking into date night at home. This was our time. We had both agreed on that. Now, I sat down and I asked him, "What are you working on?" And after a minute or two of intently listening to him discuss a big project at work, I jumped up and I said, "Hold on, wait just a minute, I need to get a snack." So I ran to the kitchen, opened the fridge, checked the pantry, and had all the goodies in my arms, walked back in there, offered him a snack, sat down on the couch, and said, "Talk business to me, baby." And he and I both laughed. And I thought to myself, at first, did I really just say that? But I did, and I meant it. I wanted to know what he was working on, even if it was dorky. He and I both laughed in that moment because now I'm a person who'd prefer a conversation on leadership, finances, strategic planning, etc., versus playing a game or watching a movie. But, you know, it wasn't always that way. But 15 years have passed, and I've changed. What I enjoy has changed. What inspires me and refuels me has changed. And oftentimes, the way Joe and I spend time together, that's changed. Our goals have changed. What we do for fun has changed. And we intentionally talk about it really often, about how we've evolved both individually and collectively. You know, doing that allows us to connect on a deeper level, and our relationship is stronger because we have those intentional conversations. But it's not just me that has changed over time. We all do. Think about your team. They've likely changed individually and collectively over time, whether it's their goals, their wants, their needs, what motivates them, their skills. Over time, we all change. And, you know, the challenge at work comes from the assumption that because you've worked with someone for so long, you innocently assume that you still know who they are and where they stand and how to work with or lead them. But is it possible that changes have occurred that maybe everyone is not aware of? Maybe an employee or coworker has changed in a way that you don't know yet. But who knows? Maybe you're the one who's changed. Either way, neither of you may realize changes have occurred until it's too late. You know, one day you wake up and two really great people just aren't doing it for each other anymore. So you go your separate ways, unless you have these intentional discussions. Now, if there ever was a time for change to occur, it was 2020, right? Well, as we go into 2021, this is such a great time for you to schedule a conversation with your people to discuss changes over the past year. Now, I've got some help for you. Here are some questions to help you sort of kickstart that conversation. How have your priorities changed over the past year? Have you found any new ways to relieve stress or have fun this past year? What did you enjoy most about your work in 2020? Or what do you wish you had more time to work on? And finally, how can I help you be more successful in accomplishing what you want in 2021? All of those questions. With all of them, there must be a purpose behind the questions you ask. It's beneficial for leaders to understand both the what and the why. What are people's goals? How are they motivated? Why have they changed? That helps you correctly delegate responsibilities, evaluate performance, and put people in the right people in the right place. Intentional communication with employees and coworkers focused on creating and maintaining a mutual understanding of each other helps you lead people better. So, I challenge you, leaders, get to talking, but more importantly, get to listening.
Thank you so much for tuning in today. For the links to everything mentioned in this episode, check out the show notes. And if you'd like more practical, tactical leadership development content, go to www.vanhooser.com for my weekly blog and all the links to my social media channels. If it makes sense to start improving the leadership skills of your managers and supervisors, let's talk about training options for your team. Email me at allison@vanhooser.com.